important to learn how to balance things. The most critical lessons in all of the world's great teachings are always the same. They're always about creating harmony, creating balance, creating a generative experience which evenly applies both sides and allows them to happen the right way. Morality and ethics don't ever point to something. They don't ever make real determinations about what is this or what is that. Like, people think, morality is about not consuming alcohol, or it's about not eating meat, or it's about wearing your hair a certain way, or it's about wearing a certain kind of underwear, or wearing a certain kind of clothing, or not doing a certain kind of thing, or not having a certain kind of thought, or suppressing certain kinds of feelings. And it's not about any of those things. It's about achieving balance. If you're a prude, you need to freak out. If you're a freak, you need to tighten it up. If there's no problem, there's no problem. Go and sin no more. You cannot commit a sin in an act of love. There's only one thing in the entire universe which matters most, and that is not hurting things. But you have to do that. You have to. No one ever told you you didn't. Arise, throw off this ignorable discontent. Go forth like fire and consume that which must stand before you. But, never surrender yourself to madness. Never surrender yourself to things like bloodlust. Never surrender yourself to cheap tricks. It is not the act of war which is offensive to the gods. War is okay. Violence is okay. Remote control bomber planes that wipe out entire villages of goat herders, children, women, in the night. This is not okay. Balance, people. Natural balance. That is what you must achieve. That is what you must achieve. If you drink too much, drink less. If you don't drink at all, you need to have a drink. Everyone needs to do whatever they're not doing. If you have no belief, you need to gain some. If you have too much, you need to back it off. Balance. Children understand this stuff. Why don't you? You can. It's easy. Too much left, too much right, not enough, toward the middle. Critical mass, people. We need critical mass here. And it's happening. Why? Because the youth are invested in a new world. Yes, of course, the old people are not going to give it up easily. They're the ones who are in charge. They own everything. They have all the power. And they're invested in the world being the way it has been. But no one in this new century will be invested in that. So why do you worry so much? It is going to change. It's going to change no matter what. Who are you? What are you doing now? Life is about living it. If you're too much of one way, if you've gone too far in a direction because you believe that the universe, like this crazy Western modernist positivist worldview that says that things travel in straight lines forever, even though there's never been observed. In the whole history of humanity, the universe period, it's all curvature. It's all open, empty curvature. There are no straight lines, and there are no eventual destinations. There are no points of interest besides yourselves. You're all thinking about something that's going to happen then. Something that's going to happen then. Something that happened already. You're never thinking about what's doing to you now. What are you doing? And why? This is so important. This is so important. Balance, balance, balance. It's easy. Practice. Stand on one foot for 10 minutes every day and learn to balance. It's called yoga, people. And it's there for a reason. You need to use the tools that are available to you to become great people. If you become great people, the world won't have the problems it has.